Donc, merci, Président. Merci de nous avoir rejoints. Je te présente Gérard Poirier, qui est notre gouverneur. Je te laisse la parole, mon cher gouverneur. Let's go.
Merci, merci Jean. Good afternoon, Holger. Sorry for not being able to speak German with you. We are very proud to welcome you. I give you the floor.
Thank you for your warm welcome. Being relaxed, yes. Knowing that I'm today attending a part of Europe where we know are the best dressed men and women ever. So that's why I put my jacket on today.
Sorry for that. I'm in a visit short only.
But thank you very much. It's an honor for me to speak to you. And like you, I'm here at home in Germany. And being at home is, of course, the most safest place you can be right now. We are all here. Yes, if I see what happens in the United States, what happens in South America, in India. So we are really here on the lucky side. Even if you had a hard time, a much harder time than we had here in Northern Germany. In my state, what is the northest state, we just have, I think, 100 cases right now. That's not a lot. And so we are really on the lucky and safe side here in Northern Germany. I'm here since the 19th of March, when we stopped all traveling in the United States and then all over the world and flew home. And that was just in time being here at home. And now I'm in Zoom meetings every day. So probably I will be the president, not traveling international, but definitely with the most contacts to Rotarians via Zoom meetings, because this is really and definitely effective. And that's why I'm asking always clubs and district, please keep whatever we are learning right now and keep this, because these are really great things. And not just doing the same thing what we have done before, now virtual, but really think doing some different things right now, what we learned. For me, coming from Germany, being here right now in the center of France, it's easy. Just a click and I'm with you. And that happens with people from the United States, from Australia, from everywhere. And that's, I think that's something what is really great. And we all should keep this in our Rotary Club meetings, not just among us here, but also in our Rotary Clubs. And that's why I'm always asking Rotary Clubs, because they are independent. And I believe in the independence of our Rotary Clubs. Please have at least one strategic meeting a year and figure out yourself where you want to be in 5 years, in 10 years. That's the best way to be prepared for the future. And there are so much great things for Rotary Clubs. But again, this is for Rotary Clubs. So it's their future. And so each Rotary Club really should think about the future. And what is for me really important, should think about what is the added value my club brings to our members. This is so important if we are looking for new members in our Rotary Club. What I'm always telling, if I'm thinking about new members, what I'm always telling people in the United States is, please look for the best members you can get for your Rotary Club. Look for members what are a good fit to your Rotary Clubs. And this is so important. Simply don't take everybody. And that works pretty well in France. That works in Italy, in Germany, in Central Europe, everywhere. I think that's the way to a good retention rate. Because for us, it's really about making friends for life in our Rotary Club. And I don't have to tell it to you because you are doing it exactly this way. But we have the same problem in France, in Italy, in Germany, Switzerland, Austria, United Kingdom, nearly everywhere here in Europe. So our clubs are becoming older and older and older. And it's hard to find young professionals. But to stay relevant, we have to look for young professionals and for more women in our Rotary Clubs. No doubt. I think there's no way that we have to try that. There are several ways that we can do that. It's with satellite clubs or just changing our own clubs to be more attractive for young members. And that's what I really would like to ask all your clubs in your district, because this is important, and I can't say it enough. This is important for the future of our organization, that we will also in the future stay relevant. And we know that we can grow with new clubs, with new different clubs. But I know that happens in Germany all the time. The existing clubs, they really don't like new clubs, and they try to fight new clubs. And so for the district governors, elect and nominees here in this call, please stay bold. It's up to you. You have to be bold, and you have to be really strong to make sure that we are really can also create younger clubs. And it works. There are so many great examples with really great people in our Rotary. So, you know, in Europe, and that's in France, I know it's in Italy, that's here, that's nearly everywhere in Europe, we see our Rotary as the community of shared values. So our core values are so important for us. And it's not just service we are thinking about. It's especially ethics, business ethics. So integrity is really one important issue everywhere right now. And when we are going to marketing our Rotary clubs and telling younger people what is important, so please take this this year's theme, Rotary Opens Opportunities. And being a member of a Rotary club is not just giving the opportunity for service projects. No, it's also the opportunity for living a more meaningful life. It's the opportunity for personal growth through Rotary. It's the opportunity to increase the skills in public speaking. It's the opportunity to become, something like an event manager if you're responsible for your Rotary club. There are so many things you can learn. And again, for me, it's really important if we try to get new younger members to let them know there is something in for you, because here is an opportunity for personal growth. That's why I choose this theme, Rotary Opens Opportunities, because it works to different directions. It works to the people we serve when we are providing eyeglasses or a wheelchair or a microcredit. We are indeed opening opportunities for others, but we are also opening opportunities for us. As I said, the opportunity for personal growth, for living in a meaningful, richer life. And again, I'm always focused on our friendship and our Rotary clubs and on our integrity. That's really important for me. But when I'm always looking for younger members, there's also one saying, and that is, there is no wrong age to become a Rotarian. And so please also look for all members who are a good fit to your Rotary club, regardless of their age, because every age has something to contribute to our Rotary clubs, and especially young retirees. So they have the time, they have the time to be involved in our service projects. They have the time to do administrative jobs in our Rotary clubs, and mostly they have some money left, what is also good. And so if they have the passion and the dedication for Rotary, please invite them to become also members in our Rotary clubs. That's also important. Just when someone asks me, what is your dream after this year? I'm always saying, my dream is definitely being more interesting for young professionals, for women, and especially Rotaract. I think you know that I'm really a strong proponent of Rotaractors, because I like the way how they are working. I like the way how fast they are, how effective they are. And I really think we can learn from Rotaractors, even if they are younger. So we have this problem in Germany always. If I'm asking Rotary clubs, hey, couldn't you make your Rotaract members of your Rotary club? And then I'm hearing very often, oh, they are just 28 or 30, and we don't know where their way and their profession is. And I think, hey, trust them. you can trust them because they are really great Rotarians, and don't wait that they become 40. That's no reason to wait. Invite them immediately with 30 to become members of your Rotary Club, and I'm sure it's the right way to invite those really effective and great young people. My last years, I'm talking yet nearly too long, but so you know that's a lot of things going on in the United States right now regarding social injustice, and they call that Black Lives Matters, and that's really an issue, and not just in the United States, it's also an issue everywhere in every country, but it's always totally different. There's no country like another. It always depends on what's going on today, what is about the history in the country. And that is why when we are really looking forward for more social justice, we have to look this in an international way, because it's everywhere different, but social injustice and discrimination is definitely everywhere. And Rotarians can be proud that we launched our diversity, equity, and inclusion statement already 2 years ago. If nobody knows about what's going on today, especially in the United States. And right now we are creating an action group, a worldwide action group, to make sure that we put this into action and to help Rotary clubs here to take the right decision in this regard. Rotary is not just a club that you join, it's an invitation to endless opportunities. And that's why I'm really still love this theme. And I'm asking all of you, today is really the time for taking action. And I'm thanking Rotary clubs all over the world, especially today, Rotary clubs in France, what you have done to solve the problems during the pandemic, during the lockdown. And I heard from Gérard already what you have done. And I'm a little bit proud of our German Rotarians during this Hamburg Convention. I know that some of you visited Hamburg, and we had many more participants than we expected. And as a result, we made nearly 400,000 euro surplus. So the German Rotary clubs who contributed all of them to the convention in Hamburg. And so all of them agreed not to take the money back, but to contribute this to the Corona Response Fund of the Rotary Foundation. And that's, I think that was a good decision, because our country again was here on the lucky side, and all of us can hope that it will remain how it is and not become worse. We will see that. So, dear friends, thank you for listening to me. I'm a totally fan of Zoom meetings. Yeah, not really. I would really love to come in person to you. I love to shake hands and I love to hug, but I think we have to wait a little bit before we can do this. Thank you for listening to me. And I think there are some questions I'm going to answer. Thank you very much.
Bonjour, cher président Holger.
Bonjour.
À l'approche de la rentrée, les Rotariens espèrent avoir l'opportunité de se retrouver ensemble en réunion présentielle ou à l'occasion de manifestations comme les forums d'associations qui ont lieu dans la première quinzaine du mois de septembre en France. En France, malheureusement, depuis mi-août, le nombre de personnes positives à la COVID-19 est en augmentation. Quelles sont vos recommandations, si possible, auprès des Rotariens pour leur réunion, présentielle ou via plateforme type Zoom, et quelles aides éventuelles dédiées à la lutte contre cette pandémie sont ou vont être à nouveau mises en place par le Rotary International ou la Fondation?
Thank you, Maxime. There are of course several answers possible, because it always depends on the rules of the states, on your rules, what happens in your area. And we learned that's not always the same thing all over France. There are differences also in your country. Secondly, I think it was to expect it that the number of cases are increasing, because people coming home from holidays and schools are opening again. And we are testing a lot of more cases a couple of months ago. I think it's definitely was expected that the numbers are going up. It's right now it's about tracking people and making sure we track people and know what they're what they have done. So my recommendation is always please do as many Zoom meetings or whatever virtual meetings the platform you are using as possible. But if it's possible to meet in person, and especially if these meetings can be outside, I know many clubs in my area are simply meeting in their gardens and because there's no, it's not a big deal being outside. So if it's possible to meet in person with the required physical distance. So I think it's possible, but it's always, we need some discipline to do that. And for me, it's that's one important issue here. I think we as Rotarians in our Rotary clubs, we have to give other people in our community a good example. So we should be always, these people are doing the best thing to protect others and of course ourselves. But if it's possible and following your rules in your country, I don't see any problems in meeting in person. But again, it's about discipline and a required physical distance. I hate the word social distance. There's no social distance needed. It's about just physical distance.
You're right. So thank you for your answer, Holger.
Beyrouth a été très touchée lors de la catastrophe survenue le 4 août dernier. Au-delà des pertes humaines et matérielles, la population se retrouve complètement démunie et une catastrophe humanitaire est malheureusement possible. Notre district s'est tout de suite mobilisé pour apporter d'une part une aide financière pour la reconstruction et d'autre part étudie la mise en place d'une aide pour la livraison de semences de céréales auprès de la population via les céréaliers de notre district. Voici la question associée à ce thème. Quelles sont vos suggestions pour aider nos amis libanais qui sont en grande détresse? Est-ce que de nouveau des consignes, des aides éventuelles dédiées à cette catastrophe vont être mises en place via le Rotary International ou la Fondation? Merci d'avance pour la réponse, mon cher Holger.
This was unbelievable for all of us. I still remember the pictures, and I still remember that your president was one of the first politicians from Europe visited Beirut and promised to help. Yes, and the district governor from that area, Lebanon, reached out to me already the next morning and asking if what we can do, and what the first thing we have done is putting their account on our website for disaster relief response. So you will find this on the Rotary, on the website of the Rotary Foundation. So and to make sure that there is an account where Rotarians all over the world could transfer money. And I think because it's through Rotary, so we can also be sure that the money will go the right way. This is in this part of the world, you don't know this always, if the money really will go the right way we are expecting. But with our Rotary friends, I think we can always be sure. And I know that in other parts, from Israel, for example, they're helped because they are not able to transfer money directly. They are not able to help directly. So they took the way via Cyprus to help their friends in Lebanon. So I think it's, and there are many personal connections with Rotarians in Lebanon among district governors, but also among ordinary Rotarians. And there are also inter-country committees are taking care of each other. So there are several ways to help. I think you found already a way to help our friends in Beirut. So thank you for what you are doing here. Thank you.
En France, la COVID-19 a eu et aura à l'automne et au-delà un impact important sur l'économie de notre pays, sur la vie de nos membres et bien sûr sur les entreprises. Dans notre district, pour faire face aux effets de cette pandémie, nous avons mis en place une action qui s'appelle Aide TPE Rotary, TPE pour très petites entreprises. Le but est d'aider les dirigeants à gérer la crise dans leur entreprise. Et nous avons mis en ligne un site pour que les dirigeants puissent nous contacter et poser leurs questions. En plus, sur l'ensemble du district, nous avons mis en place 6 équipes composées à chaque fois d'un expert comptable, d'un avocat, un banquier, un chef d'entreprise. Nous aidons le dirigeant, nous le conseillons, nous mettons tout en œuvre pour qu'il sorte le mieux possible de cette situation difficile. Nous le soutenons et bien sûr, tout cela pour lui-même, pour ses collaborateurs et pour son entreprise. Il reste bien sûr le maître de sa décision finale, en connaissance de cause, puisque nous sommes intervenus et que dans la plupart des cas, nous avons pu le mettre en face de ce qui se passe vraiment. Il n'en a pas toujours vraiment conscience, étant, comme on dit chez nous, le nez dans le guidon. Peux-tu nous indiquer si ce type d'action existe dans d'autres pays et selon ce que tu as pu rencontrer déjà, quelles sont les idées complémentaires que nous pourrions mettre en œuvre pour être encore plus efficaces? Merci beaucoup, Holger.
Thank you for that. This is a really great example what is possible through Rotary. I think it's unbelievable. So, you know, there is for me, there's not so many places in the world where so many experienced people meeting, coming together every week, like a Rotary Club. And what you are telling us, that's a great example to serve the community and to serve other people, and especially other business and other companies in the community. This is the first time I heard that. I know there are a lot of going on, people are helping others, but it's the first time I'm hearing that you are really built a structure and to help small and middle businesses in your area with this team of 4 people. So thank you, that's a great idea. And this is something what we also should let other districts know what we can do. I know that we are running an initiative in Chicago where Rotary was founded, where also Rotarians are helping each other. There are many Rotarians have problems with their own businesses and how to, they don't know how to survive. And so they are building a platform in Chicago to help in the United States. Rotarians have problems with their businesses and helping them in advising them, helping them in negotiating with banks, negotiating with their people are working together. So that's a different thing. That's helping themselves. I like your approach to help these people in your area, other business leaders. So, and that's also a good opportunity to let the general public know about Rotary, that Rotary are ready to help everywhere. So thank you for that. The idea is great, and we have to look for making that more public.
Je veux dire, tout à l'heure, tu nous as parlé de l'intérêt des jeunes retraités. C'est un job pour les jeunes retraités qui ont la chance de pouvoir aider ceux qui sont encore au pilotage de leurs entreprises, de pouvoir faire cela bénévolement.
Dans le cadre toujours de l'action professionnelle, nous sommes un réseau de professionnels, c'est encore un sujet qui nous préoccupe. Donc nous avions l'an dernier les gouverneurs que tu vois, c'est-à-dire Philippe, Maxime, Gérard, Pierre et moi. Nous avions présenté pour un atelier de la convention de Hambourg, nous avions présenté un atelier qui s'appelait Rotary Insertion, c'est-à-dire Rotary Insertion pour les jeunes et pour aider les jeunes à connaître les codes et connaître les besoins des entrepreneurs dans un moment difficile, déjà l'an dernier, mais actuellement c'est encore plus difficile puisque la rentrée liée à la COVID va être et un drame pour, en France, au moins 700 000 jeunes qui vont se heurter au mur de l'emploi. Donc, nous avons dans notre district lancé cette opération et qui se développera, je pense, un petit peu en France aussi. Bon, est-ce que tu connais d'autres actions dans ce cadre-là qui a pour but d'aider, nous, en tant que professionnels, en tant que chefs d'entreprise, etc., etc., les jeunes à connaître les codes et à rentrer dans le monde du travail?
There are some other projects. Thank you for this idea, because I totally believe in our classification system, because that makes our Rotary Clubs really interesting. And that's for me also something we can, marketing our Rotary Clubs, if we are looking for young professionals, we say, hey, there's something in for you because you are part of a really group of different professions. And by the way, if I think why I became a Rotarian, that was indeed because that was the opportunity for me to meet totally different people in my city. So normally everybody is just being in his or her group, together with lawyers or doctors or whatever, but being a member of a Rotary Club, it's really an opportunity to broaden your view. And that's, I think that's really important. And there are some other ideas here. It's also providing a RILA seminar, not just for younger people, but also in your city, providing a RILA seminar for Rotaractors or for people between 25 and 30, and coming together with some of the important Rotary Club members in your area. So to connect them so that they can already be part of a network with business leaders. That's also a good option, and to let them know about this Rotary network what we are having. Another way is what my Rotary Club is also doing is supporting and advising people are leaving schools, and so and telling them what is really important. And I'm always telling them, you know, we have always on the tables of people who are looking for new and young staff members. There's also, we have left and right, and they are, the left one is a good one and the right one is a bad one. And we have always have to think about being on the right side of the table to be recognized as one people. And being a Rotaractor or being a young Rotarian, it's indeed something because we are trained in leadership and trained in public speaking, and we used to take decisions as Rotarians and Rotaractors, and that's also an opportunity to be on the right side of the table if new staff members are selected by people. So I think that's also an opportunity what we can do for those people.
Bonjour à tous, je suis Marie-Wen Amgral, représentante du Rotaract pour le district 1770. Bien au-delà de l'utilisation restreinte de MyRotary pour les Rotaract Club, il semble y avoir un manque de base juridique et administrative, procédures, notices de fonctionnement, etc. Avec la nouvelle réforme, le Rotaract réclame ces documents afin de se développer et de se mettre au niveau des Rotary Club. De plus, avec la réforme du Rotaract survenue cette année, les clubs s'interrogent sur les changements qui vont les bouleverser dans les prochains mois. Taxe per capita qui modifie les cotisations, conservation des liens avec les Rotary Club parrains. Les Rotariens sont perplexes quant à leur nouveau statut qui les rapproche des Rotariens, mais les éloigne tout à la fois d'un passage vers le Rotary Club.
Donc, une première question, Président, concerne justement, et j'ai travaillé pas mal avec Marie-Wayne qui se trouve à l'écran, on a relevé un certain nombre de choses qui tendaient à nous distancier des clubs Rotary et non pas de converger vers les clubs Rotary. La question qui se pose, c'est, penses-tu qu'il sera possible à très court terme d'avoir des règles qui seront convergentes pour amener les deux entités sur un même terrain d'égalité? Et j'aurais une deuxième question derrière, puisque qui est une conséquence de ce que je viens de poser comme question. La deuxième question porte sur le fait qu'un certain nombre d'informations rotarassiennes ne sont pas disponibles dans les, pour les gouverneurs, entre autres choses, et les districts, et qu'on est obligé de créer nous-mêmes nos bases de données avec plus ou moins de qualité. Je te remercie de ta réponse.
Thank you very much for these questions. These are a lot of questions. So let's start with the what happens. And you know, in older days, in former days, we had an idea in Rotary, and then it was developed with a pilot project, and then it took 6-7 years. Right now, what I really totally appreciate, we are taking decisions right now, like this last year when Rotaractors became, or Rotaract clubs became members of Rotary International. So that was, this decision was taken immediately. And nobody knows that time how it can happen. But it's an opportunity for us to be much, much faster. Even if we are not really know about all these things, how to implement that in our administration, we don't know about everything about rights and responsibilities for Rotaractors, and that's still under construction right now. But I like the way how we are working right now in Rotary, and that's what I really would like to proceed. Let's do things immediately, and then let's figure out if they are working, and when they are working, let's put some money into this, and if they don't work, let's stop that immediately. So we are starting with, when I was moderator, that we had first time Rotaractors at the International Assembly, what was, I think, a huge step. And what we are having right now, are we have first time ever a Rotaractor on the board of directors. And he or she will be able to speak whenever they want. The only thing, they are not able to vote. But also this can be changed in the future. And I think, why not? Why shouldn't other people than just the 17 directors have the opportunity to vote? Regarding access to my Rotary club, to my Rotary in the internet, this is something we are right now also working on. The trustees of the Rotary Foundation took the decision just a couple of weeks ago that Rotaract clubs also will be eligible to set up global grants by themselves, if they have done already one. So, but this is always under construction. So we are, I think we are making progress. And also, I also like the fact that Rotaract clubs can themselves decide their upper age limit. There is no, they don't need us at the board of directors to let them know when they have to leave their club, when they have to leave their friends. And at least what we have done with this upper age limit was nothing else than following what anyway happens in the field. So I know there are some, in Germany, they stay until normally 32. I know that the largest Rotaract club in the United States, of Birmingham, Alabama, they have their internal rule up to 35. So I think they can decide, but I think they have to decide about their upper age limit, also about their the age, the upper age limit of their board of directors in the Rotary Club, and also the age limit for new members in their Rotary Club. They are doing this. And so I'm not afraid that they are inviting 65-year-old Rotarians to become member of a Rotary Club, special, probably as a member of honor, but it's okay again. So I think we are making progress. It takes some time, but again, the other issue, what I heard, is the gap between those two clubs. It takes also some time. We know we have many, many older Rotarians in our Rotary clubs, so in France and Germany. And some of them, they need some more time to recognize that. And you know where this problem is? Rotaract clubs, Rotaractors are always between 18 and 30, some probably a little bit more. But our Rotarians are becoming every year older and older and older. So this gap is indeed becoming larger. But for me, the collaboration between Rotaract clubs and Rotary clubs, that's really, it's important that there is a mutual respect, a good understanding among these generations, at least. that with the help of Rotaract and with the, yeah, we become more and more modern thinking Rotarians, I think we can close this gap, because Rotary needs Rotaract. I think Rotary needs Rotaract more than Rotaract needs Rotary. Thank you for that question.
Merci, Holger. Pour continuer, je te présente Mélanie Dufond, que tu connais déjà très bien.
Bonjour, Holger. Je suis ravie de pouvoir te voir, même par écran interposé. Je vais te parler d'un programme qui te tient particulièrement à cœur, puisqu'il s'agit du programme d'échange de jeunes. Et avec l'équipe du district 1770, dont la chairwoman est Domiti Gernigon, qui est parmi nous aussi pendant cette conférence, nous avions quelques questions à te poser sur un petit peu l'organisation du programme d'échange. Et la première question que j'aurais à te poser concerne la certification des districts. En effet, tous les districts doivent être certifiés. Et les exigences sont fortes, ce qui est tout à fait normal. Ce que nous constatons, c'est que dans certains pays, on envoie des jeunes qui ne semblent pas forcément motivés, qui font plutôt un échange sous la pression de leurs parents, voire même de temps en temps dans un but thérapeutique. Lorsque nous signalons ce type de problème au RI, la seule réponse que nous avons est d'arrêter les échanges avec le district concerné. Sauf qu'au départ, ce district a bien été certifié. Comment pouvons-nous suivre ce type de problème et que peut faire le Rotary International dans ce genre de cas?
Thank you for that question. That's a really special question, Melanie. I think this is just for those who are involved in this. I think that's one of the problems, of the major problems of our time right now. So when in older times, youth exchange, I remember that, when youth exchange students come in trouble. So they have to write a letter. It takes sometimes 3, 4, 5 days. And then the parents wrote a letter back or phoned. And after this, all the problems were solved, because time is mostly solving problems. One of our problems today is that they are always connected online via Facebook, via Instagram, via all these things. And so they are physical in other countries, but not with their mind. They are still at home because they are connected more with their friends at home than with their new friends in different countries. That's our major problem right now. And that's, as a result, people are not as interested because they are not really arriving in the other country. The only way here is, I think, is action, to put them, to keep them engaged, to keep them in action, not to leave them alone, to put some stress on them and being involved, doing sports, being outside, and not just always on their smartphone. So that's the only solution we have. But again, it becomes more and more difficult to keep these young people on track. And that's one of our major problems. And by the way, not just in Rotary, also all the exchanges via Youth for Understanding or American Field Service, they have exactly the same problems than we have. But again, it's a difficult problem, yeah?
Juste un petit complément, est-ce que tu ne crois pas que dans la préparation ou dans la formation de ces jeunes, il y aurait quelque chose à rajouter que le Rotary International pourrait généraliser, globaliser?
But I think it's all about the selection of those students. So the districts, especially these district teams who are doing the selection, so they have a very special responsibility for those children. And I know that there are some districts they are doing a long orientation. So from Friday to Sunday with overnight stays, with sleepovers, they call that sleepovers. But during this time, they are observing these students very, very carefully. And if someone is really showing that he has not the quality, especially in socializing with others, so they don't take them on exchange. I think that's one way to make sure that we are sending the right people. And I know, on the other hand, Rotary clubs don't like if there is another or a second selection of their students. But it's if we want good students and really involved and motivated students, I think the only way is that we do a qualified selection of those people.
J'avais une deuxième question, toujours sur le thème du programme d'échange, mais un petit peu plus précisément sur les bus trips. Quasiment tous les pays proposent aux jeunes de participer à des bus trips. La plupart sont optionnels, mais dans certains pays comme l'Australie, c'est quelque chose qui est obligatoire. Malheureusement, cette année, avec la crise de la COVID-19, la plupart des bus trips ont été annulés. En France, l'organisateur a remboursé en partie les jeunes, mais certains pays comme l'Australie, qui obligent les jeunes à faire le voyage, cette année, avec la crise, n'ont pas proposé à beaucoup d'étudiants d'échange de remboursement, ce qui est un problème en termes d'image du Rotary. Et aujourd'hui, nous, à notre niveau, ne savons pas quoi faire. Qu'est-ce que pourrait faire le Rotary international à son niveau pour aider ces jeunes à récupérer l'argent et leurs familles à récupérer l'argent qu'ils ont mis dans ces bus trips qui coûtent 2, 3, 4 000 dollars de temps en temps.
Yes, I know that's an issue. It's I think they are negotiating with these travel agencies in Australia. I can't imagine that there is no way not to pay the money back. In Europe, you know, we all know that it's possible and they are doing this. Sometimes they are just getting vouchers, what is also not right, but they have something in their hands. To be honest, I have no idea how to solve this problem right now, but we will ask our responsible staff members if there is any way to negotiate this with our colleagues in Australia.
Merci, Holger. Je pense que ce serait vraiment bien, parce qu'en termes d'image globale du Rotary, ça peut vraiment avoir un impact négatif.
Merci, Mélanie. Holger, j'ai une demande particulière à te proposer. Nous sommes, bien sûr, au mois d'août, c'est pour nous le mois des effectifs. Je ne connais pas beaucoup de districts qui sont capables de charter un club en plein mois d'août. Eh bien, si, c'est notre ami Philippe Raffin, gouverneur du 1730, donc de la Côte d'Azur, qui se trouve actuellement dans l'hôtel de ville d'Ajaccio. Donc j'espère qu'il t'entend. Si tu veux bien lui passer un petit message, Holger, si tu peux souhaiter longue vie au club d'Ajaccio qui s'appelle Ajaccio Sud Corse.
Thank you very much. And first of all, these are really good news. And these are times where are not so many good news. And I would like to thank the organizers of this new club. And I would like to welcome all new members in our family of Rotary. I think that's a great moment to charter a new club. And I would encourage all the new members. Rotary opens many opportunities. You have just to take these opportunities, and that is easy. You are becoming part of a worldwide network, and you're able to make friends everywhere through your Rotary Club participants. And so that's what I'm encourage you. You can open all these doors. Rotary is providing you. It's about service. It's about youth exchange, our great programs. It's about our national and international network. You just have to open these doors and have to take these opportunities. And this will be a great moment for you. And that's what I would like to encourage all the new members in the Rotary Club. Please do everything what you can to make this enriching your life. And I think all of us, we are here present, we are doing exactly that because all of us love this organization. Thank you. Thank you for this new club. Thank you all the members chartering this club in this difficult times. Thank you very much.
Je voulais te parler de l'environnement, du nouvel axe. Et je voulais te dire qu'en ce moment, nous réfléchissons à la façon de prendre en compte ce nouvel axe dans notre district. On envisage de mettre en place un référent sur ce thème. Peut-être de créer un prix de l'environnement, éventuellement de suggérer à nos clubs qu'il devrait au moins avoir une action liée fortement à l'environnement. Quelle serait, est-ce qu'il y a une stratégie aujourd'hui qui est déjà prévue? Nous sommes dans l'attente d'avoir des guidelines pour ce genre de choses, mais déjà on a commencé à réfléchir à ce sujet.
Yes, I can thank you for that question. I can definitely tell you that's the status everywhere right now. People are thinking about that, how to make this happen and how to implement this seventh area of focus. I know that the staff members, especially those who are working on the foundation side, are right now preparing the guidelines for this new area of focus. And I know that last week, the trustees of the Rotary Foundation met and to discuss these upcoming new guidelines for this new area. But I also know that they didn't finish this job. They are still thinking about that, what to put into this area of focus, what to support, because there are so many opportunities right now coming up, and we have to make sure that that we are supporting the right projects. And all of you know it's not possible to support every project. There's simply not enough money in the Rotary Foundation. And by the way, when I can talk a little bit about that, we all know that the trustees of the Rotary Foundation decided to stop the matching of the cash contributions of Rotary clubs. And that was some trouble around the Rotary world. And I think it was also simply a mistake how it was communicated. There are better ways to communicate harsh decisions like this. But I can tell you there was just a very simple reason, because our global grants becoming every year more successful, and every year there was a higher demand for matching. And but the contributions, they don't match this, because the increase of our money wasn't in this way. So there has to be a solution, and the solution was simply not to match our cash contributions. I think there was a little bit a mistake not to tell Rotary clubs the reason behind that, why it is. I think that's obviously. So at least we are a victim of the success of our global grants in this case. But right now for this environment, they are working on good projects and on the structure, how to do this and what projects should be under this area of focus and what should be still under the others are still remaining. So water is always an issue, and water is always affecting the environment. We all know this, but it's an extra area. So they are right now figure out what fits best in what area of focus to make it easier for our fellow Rotarians in the future.
J'ai une question de la salle. C'est Luc de Mol, donc futur gouverneur. Je voudrais poser une question sur les clubs satellites et leurs dangers face au vieillissement des clubs.
Thank you. I think this is, yes, mostly unknown, our satellite clubs. There are some ways how they can be important for Rotary. So we started these clubs to make it easier to start a new club. You just need 10 people to start a satellite club. And even if a Rotary club thinks doing with less people, it's also possible. So there are many ways right now to do that. But we found out that there are other advantages having a satellite club. As I said, more Rotary clubs are not attractive for young professionals. Before sitting just among sometimes just old men, left and right, and this is sometimes not what younger people want. But with a satellite club, we can show them another opportunity to be among themselves, among young professionals, but not being separated through another club, because they are still members of the old larger club. And so starting with them, and they can do their meetings however and whatever they want to do, but coming twice a month or once a month together with all the others, learning each other and learn also about advantages to be part of the larger group, of the old group. I think this is something every Rotary Club could figure out by itself if it works. But for me, it's a good opportunity not to separate young and old, because I'm a fan of also diversity of generations in a Rotary Club. But this satellite club could be a good start, so that two times a month, so they can do whatever they want and they can do their meeting however they want to do it, in a bar probably. I know a Rotary Club in Berlin, they are just meeting in a bar, just with a drink and some pretzel sticks, and that's okay. So this is a good option, but it's also a good option to make sure that young and old are coming together once a week, once a month, twice a month. I think that's why I think it could be a good opportunity to creating a good environment for young professionals.
Une autre question de Belgique, un nouveau club qui vient d'être créé dans le nord du Hainaut avec comme nom Human Impact, faisant référence plutôt à une idée et à des valeurs plutôt qu'à une localité. Qu'en penses-tu?
I think clubs are in older times they have to pick a city name and they have to pick names you can find on the map. That changes right now. I think clubs are free. If they're happy with that name, that's okay. I think so. I think it's about the club, what they like. But what we can see more and more are so-called cause-based clubs. So clubs are created just to serve a special issue. So, and this we will see more and more clubs who are just supporting one special area of focus or just something. That's okay too. I think that's different. I personally like more diversity. That's one of the basics for Rotary. But you know, if there are other clubs who are really focused just on special causes, I think that's okay too. I think we are really has to be open what people love and how they love to run their Rotary Club model. Yes, you know, if we are talking about this issue, the General Secretary, when he's talking in the United States, he tried to tell people there is no Rotary police anywhere. So if you try to do things, try it. But we have also what we have in Europe, and I really appreciate our great team here in Zurich in Europe. They are really supporting clubs and districts, and even as a club president, you can call them whenever you want. They have, of course, follow our code of policy very strict as our staff members. So they really have to follow the code of policy, while I, as a president, has to do it. District governors by the way also the director has to do it, but you know, club members, they can show, okay, they don't have to know all about our code of policy. By the way, for me, if you ever have looked into the code of policy, this is by far too large, too huge, too many pages. I'm always saying, if you want that nobody is reading it, making as big as possible, and you can be sure that nobody will read it. So I think there's a lot to improve, make it smaller, and I think there are many silly rules in our code of policy, and we could really make it smaller and reduce many of these unnecessary rules today. But that's a task for the board of directors to do this. But there is some work to do.
Une question de Pierre Jachet. La France vient de créer une association alumni pour le pays entier, réunissant toutes celles et ceux qui ont bénéficié des actions du Rotary. Est-ce qu'il y a d'autres expériences réussies ailleurs?
Yes, there are since all our alumni are official alumni of Rotary International. What is since, I think since 5 or 6 years, the fact. Since that time, we are encouraging our alumni groups, regardless if foundation scholars or youth exchange students or RALA participants to create what we called alumni associations, and they will become official alumni association of Rotary International. What makes them official? So I know that former Rotaract students, they love to create Rotex, youth exchange students, and they are successful everywhere. So I totally appreciate. And by the way, there are some new things going on in the United States right now. And this is also to make them, or to bring them closer to Rotary International. We are thinking about, that's just in the air right now, to have something like a, not a membership, but something like a connect model to bring these alumni associations closer to Rotary International, to make them, not really part, that's to discuss right now, that's not, you can call it a non-club-based membership model, but they are of course not really members, but they are more connected with our with Rotary International, and that's what we are creating right now. And the internet and the IT will play an important role here. And the goal is definitely to keep all these alumni. And by the way, these are more today than Rotary Club members in the world. I think we have about 1.5 million alumni, all those people we are supported in the last decades. And all these people should be, and that's really what I think that's important for us, should be much closer to our organization. So I see it as a stepstone to become a member of a Rotary Club. But this is right now under construction, and there's a pilot in the United States in the Houston area. And I'm very excited if this works, if we can keep those former alumni, or not, but alumni closer in our organization.
Faut-il maintenir un nombre de 20 personnes pour devenir un club, ou pourrait-on voir à la baisse ce nombre, par exemple 15?
I think there is a good reason to keep this number of 20. Because you know, it's especially in the first years of a Rotary Club, this is, many of those people are probably not really happy and leaving a club. If you are starting with 20 and you're losing 5 members, you have still 15. If you're starting with 10 or 15 and losing 5 members, you are really, really, I think, a Rotary Club with a very low number. And we know that we are losing most of our Rotary Clubs in the first 2 years. And that's for me the reason, let's keep this number. For me, I think a really good functioning Rotary Club has to have 30 members. And then you can be very sure that this is a good club and has a good chance to grow.
Merci, Holger.
Dear Holger, I wish you all the best for you, for Suzanne, for your family. So really, really, I really appreciate your way of being, and absolutely marvelous for me to have you as international president.
Thank you very much, Ra. And I can tell you about my challenges. My challenge is not being in Zoom meetings right now. You know where my challenge is? My challenge is I'm gaining weight because the food at home is much better than on planes or during events where you normally just have chicken and cold chicken for me. So that's one of my my problems and challenges right now. I try to solve that. So thank you very much listening to me. It was a great pleasure to me to be in France, to be in the center of France. And thank you. Please stay healthy. And please, whatever happens, what I'm always saying at the end, please enjoy Rotary. Rotary has also been fun because it's something what's really enriching our life. Thank you for what you are doing for Rotary. Bye-bye. And thank you, interpreters. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Merci, Holger.
Merci infiniment.
Merci beaucoup. Au revoir.